Hello everyone, Taylor and Ava here. We are giving updates on the messy mix that is happening out there, and I don't know, everyone's just kind of, they were dreading this, yeah. And here's why. I mean, it is a mess out there.
It really is. I mean, I was driving to work around, what time was it, 7 o'clock this morning, mm-hmm. and it really just started to get going in mm-hmm. downtown, and then by the time I finally made it into work, there was actually a layer of sleet on the roads, and that's just in the city. I mean, we're talking the worst conditions being felt across our northern suburbs from this point forward, mm-hmm. and that's something we're going to be watching pretty closely ongoing throughout this afternoon. So here's why.
Yeah, so I'm putting the radar in motion because you can see there's a heavier band that is now setting up in Carroll County, so right around Westminster, also pushing into Cockeysville again, so Baltimore County is about to get that slightly heavier band. And the trouble is, not only is that reduced visibility on the roads, but then it allows, you know, when it comes down heavier like that, it can start to stick more to surfaces. And so far, the reports I'm seeing anywhere from about a half inch to an inch and a half. Mm-hmm. We would love to hear from you guys if you're seeing more than that in your neighborhood. Taylor's manning some of the comments right now on the Facebook page. So comment, let us know where you are, and let us know what you're seeing. So that's probably what caught a lot of people by surprise. You know, it's early in the year, and I don't think, even though we called for snow to stick, I think a lot of people were hoping it wouldn't.
Yeah.
But it's cold out there.
It is, and the pavement temperatures are coming too near the freezing mark and even below. So, again, that kind of causes some concern from at least going to this afternoon, especially across anywhere just north of the city. Could we see, you know, some of this activity freeze on the roadways mm-hmm. once it changes over to rain, or even if it does change over to rain? So it's going to be, you know, this is also something that we typically see in the month of March, I would say, mm-hmm. kind of the transition season. So it's very unusual for this time of year. I know I grew up in this area, and you've been working here for several years, that we typically don't see this kind of event in November before Thanksgiving.
Yeah, that's what's tricky. So it kind of catches people off guard, and you've got to remember how to handle this kind of stuff. You know, that's what Taylor was mentioning, the fact that these areas, I've kind of just quickly circled them right now, north and west of Baltimore, so you're talking north of 70, north of the Beltway, north of 95, those areas are below freezing now and may not warm up. In fact, I should have put BWI in that, because they're below freezing too, and they were supposed to have warmed up by now. So I think that if there's any change to the forecast, we're talking the north and west suburbs mm-hmm. being worse.
Yes.
Maybe not in total amounts, maybe not more snow, but the fact that the conditions on the ground can stay icy longer.
Yeah, and look at the temperatures right now. I mean, we're mm-hmm. in the 20s in Westminster, and that has actually dropped over the past 2 hours or so. 31 Parkton, 32 in downtown. So I think anywhere just north of downtown is something we're really going to focus on. As you just said, that we could see road conditions stay pretty bad even mm-hmm. later on tonight.
Are you hearing from anyone jumping in on social media? I don't know if people are commenting on what they're seeing. Let's see, we can pick out a few areas.
Tina just said we have about an inch in Elk Ridge.
Okay,
saying back roads are getting pretty bad.
And where is that, I wonder? Just anywhere. Yeah, that's the trouble with this, is that when this ground surface is cold like that, I mean, when you have temperatures in the upper 20s and low 30s, anything that's coming down is going to stick, even if it's in the middle of the day.
Right.
Especially because it already laid a cold surface, and then things pile up on top of that. And so the roads that were not treated are going to be worse. A lot of the main roads look a lot better, but even on those main roads, you may have some slush in between lanes, which is dangerous at high speed.
Right. Let's see. I'm trying to stay on top of these comments.
I guess I can quickly talk about where it looks better. you know, we always focus on the bad stuff, but Annapolis, Centerville, Easton, this has mainly been a rain event for
you. We are getting some comments from Anne Arundel County, some people saying that there are a lot of accidents everywhere.
Interesting. So, and I wonder what part. Are they talking kind of where the battle zone is.
Yes, and anyone who's commenting from Anne Arundel County, could you please say where you're located? Because we're kind of seeing that line go right through the county. Mm-hmm. So if you're in Glen Burnie, Odenton, you're probably seeing a mess.
Yeah, we'd love to know where you're falling, because the radar can only do so good of a job trying to figure out what's actually falling. So that's, I guess, what's troublesome about this. You know, Baltimore City and Anne Arundel County schools stayed in session because they were kind of banking on the fact that those areas would stay warmer. That's kind of not the case. Now, the one thing we can hope for is those areas do typically warm up with the daytime heating.
Right.
The hope is, at least if it's kind of icy now in Anne Arundel County and Baltimore City, that as the afternoon goes on, I'll push you to, 2:30 when, you know, parents are picking up kids from school or kids are walking home.
And we're getting some questions.
Hopefully
when will
more rain.
Rise?
Yeah. Hopefully it's more rain by then. What are people saying?
They're asking when will the temperatures rise?
That's the trouble. I mean, RPM shows kind of what we expected. The northern suburbs really not warming up through 3 o'clock, but even around Baltimore, maybe it takes until 2 o'clock to completely warm above freezing. So that initial part of people getting back on the roads could be a little slick, but it's not going to be nearly as bad because mm-hmm. places like Baltimore City, Annapolis, the Eastern Shore, they're going to warm up quicker and hopefully go more to a plain rain. If they can put some salt down on the roads that are icy right now, it should be a lot better. It's the northern suburbs that, like, you know, the road crew's in a tough spot. There's no way they can really catch up to this.
Definitely. And we're getting some reports. Linda just said in Addington and Harford County, it's snowing really hard.
Interesting. Yep. Makes sense.
A lot of accidents in Harford County.
Yeah, this is a lot of precipitation, and unfortunately, it is leaning colder. It doesn't necessarily mean we're going to see more mm-hmm. total snow mm-hmm. because there's going to be a lot of compaction still because it's mixing with so much sleet. But what it does tell me, so that's not the big story here, the fact that it's getting colder. The big story is probably that the ground surfaces, where you typically would expect them to get better in November during the middle of the day, they may not. So really, at any point today, if you don't have to travel, especially north of the city, I would avoid it.
Yes.
I'll go to our timeline, and you know, one thing I forgot to add on this, in fact, I'll try to type it in while we're talking, it's going to turn breezy tonight. So that brings in a whole nother issue when you've got ice accumulation possibly on tree mm-hmm. limbs and power lines in our northern mm-hmm. suburbs, and then you add in a wind on top of that, you cause branches to break, you cause power lines to go down. So this, because it stays colder longer, this could go into more of a power outage issue when we originally thought that wouldn't be the case if it went to all rain.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And we can't afford to lose our heat right now.
Yeah, I know. it's cold. I mean, it's unusually cold. We're, even the next couple of days, it only warms to the 40s, which it should be the 50s this time of year. So this mm-hmm. is the timeline, which people want to know. Some places go to rain this afternoon. Right. Others don't.
Right. And I think, like, the key point from this point forward also is location. Mm-hmm. So you may be watching from Southern and Arundel County mm-hmm. right now, and you also may be watching from Cecil County right now. Mm-hmm. Totally different spectrum of what we'll be dealing with this afternoon. So if you're located, again, across our northern suburbs, this could turn into a very slick event mm-hmm. even through tonight. If you're in Southern and Arundel County, this should mainly be a rain event.
Yeah, the hope is. I guess we will watch Northern and Arundel really closely because as we're seeing, because they're below freezing now, where will it warm? But that's the hope, that at least Anne Arundel County and the city warm above freezing may not be the case for areas northwest of that. And then as we go through this evening, you could get a mix of rain to the south, maybe some ice to the north, then you add the breeze on top of that. That could cause some power outage issues. And then there could actually be one last burst of snow going mm-hmm. into the night, so that could mean extend the possibility of slick roads into the Friday morning commute. Originally, we hoped, hey, if it goes to rain, it washes all the snow and sleet from today. We start over with mm-hmm. that, then we're not going to see much tomorrow morning. That may not be the case now if we stay completely cold. And this is what I'm talking about here. The future cast hints at a little bit of wraparound precipitation. So we get this dry patch mm-hmm. through about 6 and 7 o'clock. That's the storm system transferring energy, so you get a little break. But then what happens is you get the wraparound piece of it. Here's 3 in the morning. There's still snow showers maybe towards Westminster and Baltimore County. And what would have been better if it had been rain back to a snow shower, that's fine. Mm-hmm. But if they stay more of an ice and then they get the snow shower, that just ensures that there's going to be icy spots through tomorrow morning.
Exactly. So,
We'll go back to the timeline.
We're just getting a lot of reports right now. It's snowing in Towson. The roads are mm-hmm. bad in Towson, too. Yep. Coming down in Ellicott City. All the comments that we are getting from Anne Arundel County, because some people are upset that the schools are still in Anne Arundel County, is that they were all from northern Anne Arundel County. We're talking Glen Burnie.
So we're about to go on air real quick, but I guess I'll just leave you with a radar image here. Again, you can see where it is snowing in Clarksville, Towson, Westminster, basically everywhere north and west of 95, but you're still seeing some snow in northern Anne Arundel County, or at least some sleet. So those are the zones that have stayed icy or longer. So be really careful even in that zone, at least for the next few hours.
Yes.
We appreciate you joining us on Facebook Live. We are actually about to go live on TV as well, so I won't want to miss that hit. But keep checking with WBAL. We're going to keep you updated online on social media and on your app as well. So thanks for joining us.
Stay safe.